Okay, YouTube friends, what I want to show you today is something kind of different for me. It's not about chickens or honeybees. I have an earthen pond in my backyard. It's 14 feet deep. It's 120 feet across. And over the past few years, I've got invasive grasses growing into it. And I went online and I went to Amazon, you know, cutting aquatic grasses and weeds, and I bought a weed cutter and I bent it right away, wasted my money. And then it occurred to me, in the garage, I've got this hand-me-down old scythe. And I just thought, what? Every time I tried to use this thing, I would go out and try to cut weeds because I thought it would be cool to do something that was retro. And I would take that scythe and I would draw it against the weeds. And it wouldn't cut very well, so I just hung it back up in the garage and decided not to use it. So then I looked it up on YouTube. I mean, we learn everything from YouTube these days, and maybe that's why you're watching me right now, but it's rare to actually do a search for a scythe or a sickle and find out how to properly use, you know, a reaping tool like this. So I just took my, you know, sharpening stone out, sharpened it up a little bit. They say you're also supposed to peen these edges. So you tamp it with a peening hammer, hopefully on an anvil, and you'll draw out the edges of it so it's nice and thin so that you can put this razor edge on it. So I did that, sharpened it up, and again, then I watch a YouTube and I saw that they weren't grabbing it and drawing it across. They're actually swinging it in a radius and it slices the weeds instead of chopping at them, which is what I was doing, and that was completely wrong. So I came out to the pond and I did a little quick practice with the scythe, and I did that nice, easy turning, slinging motion, and I could not believe how easily it cut these aquatic grasses down. These things are like 13 feet tall, they're taking over the pond, and it cuts them so quick and easy, I thought, you know what, I'm gonna put up a YouTube and show you guys how I took care of my invasive grass species right here on my pond. So I'm gonna speed it up so you don't have to watch me doing it for a long time. But you will not believe how well one of these old scythes works to cut tall grass, reeds, cattails, anything you need to get rid of out of your pond. Use one of these. If you don't have one, this was handed down. If you don't have one, these are sold in antique shops and stuff to be put on people's barn walls. Way better than a weed whacker. You can get up on Sunday morning, go out in your yard, and take out high brush that's been neglected for a long time, and your goats will follow you around if you have goats, and we do. They'll follow you around and just eat the stuff that you trimmed down. So watch this, it's pretty amazing. This is what I did earlier to test it out. Remember, you know, before I was grabbing it and just chopping into everything, that's not the way to go. So instead you do a nice, easy 180 degree twist, and this will take care of all your treadmill requirements too. Go ahead and get a nice cardio using one of these. Here's my water lilies. They've been covered by this tall grass all this time. Get yourself a scythe, forget the weed whacker. Thanks for watching.